In the last video, we made our JavaFX line chart subscribe to prices from our Reactive Spring Boot service and display them in real time. In this video, we're going to update the chart so that it subscribes multiple times and can show multiple sets of prices on the same chart. The chart controller, which manages how the data gets to the view, contains a call that subscribes the chart controller itself to the client that listens to the price service. We need to change this so we can have more than one subscriber. Let's create a new type, a price subscriber, which manages everything to do with consuming prices from the client. We'll create this as an inner class. We know from the last lesson that this accept method is the one that deals with the prices. So let's move this into the price subscriber and make a small change to get the price subscriber to compile. We want the price subscriber to manage the series data, as this is the collection that gets updated by the accept method. We also need the price subscriber to know the symbol. Each subscriber is responsible for managing a single stock. We'll get IntelliJ IDEA to create the appropriate constructor and to create a field for the symbol parameter. Since each stock also corresponds to a single series in the chart, we can also move the creation of the series into the price subscriber. Let's move the series into a field so we can use it elsewhere in the class. We can make all these fields final since we're not going to change them anywhere once they're initialized. We need to add a getter for series because the chart controller will need to get this series to add it to the chart. Let's extract the price subscriber into a local variable. We're going to need to use this elsewhere in the method. To declare this as final, we can hold down Alt and press the F key. Let's move this price subscriber near the top of the method. Now we can get the series from it to add it to the chart. The chart controller still doesn't compile because we said it still implements the consumer interface, which it doesn't anymore. So we need to delete this. If we rerun the application, the chart should run the same way it did before, assuming we still have the backend service running as well. Since we haven't changed the behavior, just refactored the subscription code. Now we want to add our second subscriber. Let's rename our symbol to symbol1, since we're going to have another one of these. And let's also rename our price subscriber as well. We can duplicate these lines and make them work for a second symbol. The second symbol and price subscriber are needed for a second subscription to the client that retrieves prices. We also need to add our second series to the chart to display the second set of prices. Let's rerun the application to see if this has worked. Now we can see two different series on the chart tracking the prices for two different stocks. Now we have the application working the way we want, we can refactor the code if we wish. For example, we might want all the code that sets up the subscription for each symbol in the same section of the method, so we could move the call to subscribe to the top, near where we create the subscriber. We can clean up any warnings, so here we can make the inner class static as suggested. And although we thought we might need symbol as a field, it turns out we don't need it elsewhere in the class, so we can convert it to a local variable. IntelliJ IDEA automatically inlines this, since it's only used in the call to the series constructor. So now we have a JavaFX application that subscribes to more than one price from our Spring Boot service, and displays each set of price data in real time in multiple series on a line chart. Thanks for watching.